Huntington's very own School of Rock is here and in session. Find out how to turn your child's rock star dreams into a reality, next on In Focus. Welcome to In Focus, a weekly public affairs program that looks at topics of interest to residents of Orange County. In Focus is produced by the students enrolled in the digital media program at Golden West College. I'm Sandra Roby, your host of In Focus. Joining me in the studio is musician, owner, and founder of Rockstars Music Studios, Ryan Von Tile. Ryan, thanks for being here.
Thanks for having me.
So now tell me about Rockstars Music Studios.
Sure. Well, so we're a private music school in Huntington Beach, and we teach lessons in guitar, piano, singing, drums, and bass.
So now, why do you focus on rock stars? Why did you choose that name?
Well, when I first got started, I actually took a job teaching at another school in a different city and just wasn't happy with the way kids were being taught, wasn't really lining up with current music and how they were interested in. So we decided to make a change and teach them modern music, rock songs, things like that they could understand and relate to and use all the same important principles of teaching music, but in a much more fun way.
Yeah, do you think that the students playing music that's contemporary makes it more interesting and real to them?
Absolutely. You know, I can go on YouTube and I can look up a song by Justin Bieber or an old band like the Eagles or whoever. But if I say, hey, we're gonna play this amazing Mozart song, there's nothing I can relate that to other than someone else who played a Mozart song before.
I have to admit, with my kids going up through school, one of my favorite memories is the elementary school band playing We Will Rock You.
Yeah.
And it was the most anemic We Will Rock You you've ever heard.
I bet it was.
But it was the best I've ever heard, too.
I'm sure they loved it more than anything.
Yes, exactly. So now, why should parents consider incorporating music into their children's extracurricular activities?
In addition to, all the important, all the basic stuff that everyone knows about, developing the brain and things like that, it's really, for us, it's more of a confidence development that they gain. I'm in the lucky position where I see these kids come in at the ages of 7 and 8, and I stay with them, and they work with us until they graduate high school. And they just turn into these, you see them transform into someone who's shy and timid, and they get on stage, and then all of a sudden there's this big, boisterous personality that comes out, and it's really special to see.
That must be so thrilling and rewarding to see the change and the growth that happens in these students.
Absolutely.
So now, what would you recommend with parents when they go to their children to select an instrument?
It depends on their age and what the kids' interests are. It's always great to start with the piano because it's a simple instrument, especially for younger kids. It's very easy. It's very visually responsive to them, just being able to see what note to hit, and it makes a good sound.
But isn't that hard to have a piano at home? I mean, if they're going to practice?
No, not anymore. You can have a very basic keyboard for $75, $100. That's a great place to get started. If the kid's really interested in guitar, we always recommend electric guitar. It's a lot easier to play. It's fun to play, so they can plug it into the amp, turn up the distortion. It makes this loud sound that they, want them just mess around with, so that's a really fun instrument as
now,
well.
What are some of the most interesting instruments or unusual instruments you have going on at Rockstars?
We keep it pretty simple, actually. So we have guitar, piano, bass, drums, singing. We actually do a ukulele class that comes in a couple times throughout the year.
Ukulele?
Yeah, it's a lot of fun.
I want to do that. It's four strings, right?
Uh-huh, yeah, four strings. And so they come in, and we have a really great teacher who comes in and hosts the class at our studio. So that'd probably be the most unique, I'd say.
So what's unique about your methods of teaching at Rockstars?
What's unique, ultimately, is that we're taking modern music and we're taking traditional classical music education techniques and combining them together. So a lot of classical schools, what they'll do is they'll only teach that and you have to be able to read and all these things. And some modern schools will only teach modern music, but they'll miss out on the education. So we try to bring both together.
So what is your favorite memory of teaching students right now at Rockstars? Favorite?
My favorite memory is pretty simple. It's the first concert we ever did where we put kids together in a band. And we do these rehearsals and it was a total mess. And we're like, oh man, it's not gonna pull off. Then gets to the show and we're fingers crossed, and I got to sit in the back. All of a sudden, I'm seeing the concert's coming off amazing. The kid nails his solo that he'd been working on for 6 months, and parents are just thrilled, and that was one of the best memories we ever had.
That is so wonderful. We are so happy to have had you here. Rockstars Music in where?
Huntington Beach, California.
Huntington Beach, California. Thanks so much, Ryan.
Thank you.
Now, according to research studies, middle school and high school students that participate in music score higher than their non-band peers on standardized tests. Rockstar Studios is located on Beach Boulevard in Huntington Beach. For more information, visit their website at rockstarmusic.net or give them a call at 714-962-8525. So we are out of time, but I would like to thank my guest, Ryan Von Teil, for joining me today on In Focus. Thank you.